All right, here we are.
Episode number 288. 288 live streams.
288 live streams since lockdown. Right, Lulu? Right, Caroline?
Okay.
Are we sitting comfortably? Well, then I'll begin.
Thank you.
but I'm not going to ship.
For a while, man.
Shiver me timbers. Actually, after I get done with this little moment musical, I will treat you to a Fleischer Brothers cartoon with Popeye and Wimpy and Olive Oil entitled Shiver Me Timbers from, about 1930 when they were good, pre-Hays Code. And this interpolates a little bit of the Flying Dutchman motif, albeit with their Bargain Basement 42nd Street Orchestra. They did all these things really right off Times Square in kind of a boiler room operation. Very, very creative sound design on all those old Popeye and Betty Boop cartoons. And, you know, they used some of the top jazz talent who was around in those days playing in, you know, whatever Yiddish theater, Times Square musicals, whatnot. They had this gig with the Fleischer Brothers in their old studios. Anyway, those were the days, my friend. So what have we here? Well, this is, I guess, I asked my webmaster, Tanya Wienan, who archives my stuff at GaryLucas.com, to give me a count of how many of these live streams I'd done since lockdown back in March 1990. This one, I believe, is number 288, as mentioned at the top. I'm still enjoying giving them, if you're enjoying tuning in. I know some of you are hardcore and you never miss one, or you make up for it. They're all archived in any case. And I've done what I could to improve the sonics recently. And I just thought I would roll out the Flying Dutchman Overture, played with my fingers only, which is how I planned to do it when I did this at MIT with this great dancer, Allison Clancy, last Friday night up in Cambridge, Massachusetts. But in the rehearsals, it was deemed that it was better articulated with the flat pick. I favor a jazz 3 Dunlop flat pick, so I rolled that out. But in this setup over here in the corner, I just find that it's easier to use my fingers. Plus, I think, I don't know, it adds a certain piquant attack to the pedal setup. And anyway, I'm getting ready. Both of us are getting ready to go away. I'm going away to Europe for a month for some shows and a variety of things. Caroline is a three-weeker, but we're going to go, first of all, to Budapest, one of my favorite destinations. I first played there, oh my gosh, under the auspices of the Knitting Factory, come to think of it, back in 1993. Michael Dorf led a troupe of merry men and women on a thing called the Jam Tour, which at that point stood for Jewish Avant-Garde Music. And I was there doing my soundtrack accompanying the Golem, the 1920 German Expressionist silent film that Walter Horn and I first composed the score. Oh boy, back in the day, 1989 it was, for David Schwartz at the Museum of the Moving Image, which had just opened up there in Astoria, very close to where the Marx Brothers filmed The Coconuts and the famous Astoria Studios once existed. Anyway, they've turned it into a high-end soundstage, mainly for film and TV, and I think a lot of the Sopranos episodes were filmed in there, or at least certain parts of it that weren't on location. So, well, that really brings me back. But that was a fun tour, and I think Michael wrote me not so long ago that he filmed a lot of this. He had a cameraman. I can tell you, yeah, there were moments that were quite taxing. We did about 20 shows in 21 days, hopscotching all over Europe by planes and boats, no boats, planes and trains and buses. But there were some wonderful memories that I have I can never forget these emblazoned on my brain, which, well, I'll wait till the appropriate moment to drop these memories. I mean, share them with you is right now. But I digress. So, yeah, I'm getting ready. The first stop is Budapest. And I first played at Petőfi Hall, which is a very, very big venue upon arriving. After we played, I think the tours commenced in Prague, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah. And we were there at the Reduta Jazz Club not that long after Bill Clinton had tootled a saxophone there. This is 1993. It was a wonderful experience. Going to all these places, we hit Budapest afterwards. Maybe the next day. How do we get there? I gotta recall the itinerary, but there were a lot of stops, including a visit to Dachau. Anyway, Michael has this all archived. He's recently contacted me and said he digitized it. I would do the Golem night after night. I've done it with Walter Horn, my childhood friend, originally. We developed this score for keyboard and electric guitar, and acoustic guitar. But on that tour, I had Anthony Coleman, who was there with God as my co-pilot, subbing on a few nights on keyboards. He did a fine job, as did Frank London, a giant of Jewish music, as he says, on keyboards. He played a mean keyboard, but he was mainly there with Hasidic New Wave. So anyway, we had some great fun and adventures, and I do hope that this film comes out, this documentary, I don't know what stage they're in, but a lot of it was recorded and digitized recently, so we shall see. But I'm still living some of these memories. But Budapest is fantastic, so Caroline has never been there. I'm treating her. She is really deserved of a nice trip out of New York City at this point. I mean, we're all pretty much feeling like, you know, the worst of the COVID is over for the time being. We're certainly all vaccinated up to the hilt, and we shall see. I'm still wearing a mask out there, to tell you the truth, as is she. Not for any virtue signaling reason, only because at this stage of the game, I don't really want to be slowed down, because I feel just pretty good about everything in the world of music these days. And, you know, nobody needs to get sick. And I recently, for Mother's Day, posted a picture of my mom on her honeymoon. She was an early COVID victim, as I've mentioned. And it was quite horrible, that whole episode. But anyway, I've been pretty active touring despite all this. Yeah, and ready to do it all over again, because I love to play live. This is where this is my favorite part of the trip, as Jim Morrison once said. It really is. There's nothing that beats the live experience, especially when you get a good audience and you can feel this palpable wave of feedback. And I like to take audiences on trips, so I hope to be doing this Flying Dutchman score standing up. That'll be a new experience, because it was a lot of work to put it together. And I'm hoping Allison Clancy and Dan Safer are going to send me a clip from MIT. You know, watch for that. It should arrive by the end of the week, hopefully, though. Gussied up, or whatever they're doing to it. It was recorded, and we really did have a great concert that night. So, yeah, well, that should be coming out. I want to thank the manufacturer, too, because upon request, they sent me this terrific Fela Kuti box set of vinyl with some of his best stuff. And some of the best music I ever saw in my life was when Fela Kuti was released from prison, where he'd been for some years in Nigeria. And he had a triumphant concert at the Felt Forum in New York. And I was a tremendous fan. I had been following him for some years and purchasing original African pressings. There used to be a record store in the West Village called 99 Records, run by Ed Bauman. They actually had a label, but he carried a lot of this stuff. So that's how I first heard it. And then Chris Blackwell signed Fela to Island, and more of it became available. And he certainly was on the way of becoming, if not the next Bob Marley, but certainly the biggest name in what has come to be known as world music. I mean, his story is amazing. But anyway, they clamped him in jail for a while because he was really making too much trouble for the repressive government. But, eventually, due to public demand, he served some time and they let him out. And, he came with then to New York with a new lineup called Egypt 80, and that's the band that I saw at the Felt Forum, and that was just terrific. Anyway, I love to hear the old Fela recordings, and most of them, at least 30 of them, have come out vis-a-vis the Knitting Factory label, who've put my work out, and certainly they've done a commendable job in bringing Fela's legacy alive again as living music. And then there was the Fela musical on Broadway, and my friend Steve Handel is one of the main movers and shakers behind that. He took it to Lagos, actually, and to Amsterdam. Actually, I was over there doing my Chinese project, The Edge of Heaven, for the Holland Festival, the number one Dutch arts festival, back in, I think this is 2012, with two fantastic singers I imported. I went to Shanghai, actually, courtesy of the Holland Festival, to audition singers, and had Sally Kwok on one of the vocal parts, and a young, very, very talented young lady from the Central Dramatic Arts Academy in Shanghai, Maggie Mo, aka Mo Hai Chin, on the other part. And Gods and Monsters was the house band that was for that lineup. Let's see. We had Ernie Brooks on bass guitar, who I played with forever. And on drums, Billy Ficca. Ernie was in the Modern Lovers, Billy was in Television. Did we have keyboards on them? Maybe we had Joe Hendel and Jason Candler. Joe was playing keyboards, Jason playing saxophone. And we had some excellent concerts. There's some clips that are still floating around, probably on YouTube, and I think I put some up on Vimeo. But we had some great shows, and that was a lot of fun. But anyway, I have a volume 2 and 3 coming out featuring great mainland singer and arhu virtuoso Fefe Yang and Jason Candler on sax and percussion. That should be out in December through Rare Lumiere, and I'll tell you more about it as we get closer to it. But right now, I'm still surfing the wave of Double Dare, featuring young Dutch acoustic bassist Peter Willems. He's also a fine singer. I'm heading to do a show with Peter in Maastricht, which is really one of my favorite cities to play in these days. They're near the Belgian border in southern Holland. And we are playing on June 8th, I think it is. It's a Wednesday at St. John's Church, St. Jan's Kerke, in Maastricht. So people who are in that region, please be advised, because I'm coming there directly from playing in Dresden at the Tonne Jazz Club, which I haven't played for some time, but I can't wait to get back into Germany and play. Germany used to be my base for many a year. And I must have done, oh gosh, at least 80, 90 cities, big ones, little ones, ones without names even, railroad crossings, some good ones, though. I had a very, very proactive agent in the period before they slapped a 40% foreign artist tax, which they did shortly before I went on stage in Hamburg. I was informed that they were going to take a bigger cut than normally because of this big foreign artist tax. Which was probably not the right thing to say to the artist before he was going on stage. But nevertheless, can't wait to do that one. And that is on June 4th, Saturday night. I have two great singers local to Dresden are going to join me in a tribute to Jeff Buckley. The night before, I'm at the Sunset Jazz Club in Paris, Friday, June 3rd. And I have two great female vocalists who are going to join. Jean-Philippe Riquiel on keyboards, Lucas Ligeti on drums, Alain Niame on bass, and myself for a tribute to Jeff plus other stuff. And that is the two singers. Estelle Perrault, who is a French-Asian singer who's going to tackle Hallelujah. And just added to the lineup, Marilyn Marilani, a Haitian singer who's based in Paris for some time now, a jazz singer, both of them. So I'm very excited about that. And prior to that, I'm going to be in Ireland over the May 28th in Galway at the Loft. And May 29th, which is actually the 25th anniversary of Jeff Buckley's untimely passing, in Dublin at the fabulous Waylands, which I played two or three times previously. I love to play in Ireland. I can't wait for these shows. And but the whole trip is starting out in Budapest. It's a long story, but for some well-deserved R&R, you can't beat Budapest. Lovely city, I totally recommend it for a one, you know, great out of the way, at least for most Western players based in the U.S. destination. It's just so beautiful and congenial. And so that's about it, except, well, what am I going to read on this trip? Here's two books. I just got them. Okay. One is translation of stories by Ivan Turgenev called Love and Youth, a beautiful edition that comes recommended. And then I just got in this Fernanda Melchior, a young Mexican author who's very, very, shall we say, vivid on the darker side of things. And this is called Paradis with a new translation. And I love Latin American fiction anyway, so I can't wait to read it, and they're certainly the right size to carry on a plane to and from. Okay, so that's it for now, and I'll see you on Thursday, which is probably going to be my last live stream for a while, at least till I come back from this excursion. And thanks again for tuning in. Love to play for you guys. And I hope to see you on the road out there somewhere. All right, man. Be well. Let's like get the right angle here for the farewell. All right, man. Talk to you soon. Love to you.